Hey everyone, welcome back. Today we're going to really do a deep dive into Accucrazy.
Oh yeah.
They're making some big moves in AI marketing.
For sure.
Yeah, their goal is to like totally revolutionize content creation. And they just came out with this new product.
I know, right?
It's called the Pocket Company. It's pretty wild. We've got a presentation from their CEO Ian on it, and of course we've dug into their website too.
Always got to do the research.
Yep, absolutely.
So what's super interesting about Accucrazy is that they're constantly evolving. I mean, they started in 2017, right? Like focused on digital marketing.
Right, yeah.
Which is already super fast-paced.
Oh, tell me about it.
But then they went all in on AI.
Yeah.
And jumped right into content tech. That's a big shift.
It is. That takes some serious guts, especially when you consider they're already making $1 million a day.
It's crazy.
That's just insane. Plus, they've got big names like NVIDIA and AWS backing them up. Not to mention, they've already worked with over 300 brands.
Yeah, that's not too shabby.
Not bad at all. Okay, but let's get down to business. What exactly is this pocket company thing?
It sounds a little like science fiction, to be honest.
Well, it's a pretty bold idea, that's for sure.
Yeah.
They're calling the Pocket Company their new AI agent service.
Okay.
And it's got three different tiers.
I see.
The first one is like a single agent.
Got it.
So that's like having a specialized AI assistant, you know, for specific tasks, like writing social media posts or something. Then you've got the model as a service tier.
Okay.
And that one's more for professionals, like journalists or writers.
Makes sense.
Anyone who creates content, really.
So, like, instead of having to hire a ghostwriter.
Yeah. It's almost like having a personalized ghostwriter, one that's tailored to your writing style.
Okay. Now, that's pretty cool. But you said there were three tiers, right? What's the third one?
All right. So, this is where it gets really wild.
Oh, good.
The third tier is the multi-agent level.
Okay.
Accucrazy is thinking long-term here.
Yeah.
They see this as, like, a fully AI-powered company. Hold on. You're saying I could have a whole AI-powered company in my pocket.
That's the idea.
How does that even work? What's the secret sauce?
Well, they built this thing they call an AI data flywheel.
Okay.
It's basically a system that's constantly learning.
Interesting.
So they feed user data back into their models.
So it gets smarter over time.
Exactly. And they're smart about it. They're not trying to reinvent the wheel.
Oh, huh.
They're using large language models like ChatGPT.
Oh, yeah. Everyone's talking about ChatGPT.
Right. But then they go a step further. They use this chain of thought fine-tuning method.
What's that?
Basically, it trains the AI to think more like a human, you know?
Oh, so it's not just spitting out random words.
No, it's understanding the context and intent.
It's a pretty big deal, right?
It's a huge step forward in AI content creation, for sure.
This is fascinating stuff.
Right.
But I'm a real world kind of guy.
I hear you.
So can you give me a concrete example of how this pocket company thing is being used right now?
Yeah, absolutely. They've got this thing called Moana.
Moana, like the Disney movie?
Kind of, yeah. But it's an AI-powered solution for social media.
Oh, interesting.
It's like a virtual influencer, but it creates engaging content all on its own. It understands trends and interacts with people in real time.
That's wild. And what's this about Moana being good at creating content in Taiwanese?
Oh, yeah. It's pretty cool, right?
Yeah. But why focus on one specific language like that?
Shows they're thinking strategically.
Yeah.
They're not just going after the biggest markets, you know?
Yeah, they're finding those niches where their tech can really shine.
Exactly. Having AI that can create content in Taiwanese, that's a big advantage in that market.
That's really smart.
It is. They're thinking outside the box.
Yeah.
But you know, you mentioned earlier about the model as a service tier.
Right. Yeah.
And then there's also that pocket news thing, right? Their AI-powered news agency.
Yeah. How do those two connect?
Well, they're actually linked. Pocket News uses that model as a service tech to create a whole platform for automated news content.
Wow. So it's like having a team of AI journalists working 24/7.
Basically. Yeah.
So journalists could use this to write articles faster.
Yeah. And Pocket News takes care of SEO optimization, too.
So the content is more likely to get found online.
Exactly. And they even offer an API.
Oh, so other companies can use this tech, too.
Yep, they're definitely going after that B2B market as well. All right, so we've got this pocket company that can create all sorts of content.
Right.
But how does it stack up against something like ChatGPT? Everyone and their grandma is using that these days.
Yeah, good point. So how are they different?
Well, ChatGPT is amazing for text-based stuff, but Accucrazy is doing more.
Okay.
They're combining that with their Luna AI model.
What does Luna do?
It specializes in short-form videos, you know?
Oh, like TikToks and Reels.
Exactly. And they're adding digital human technology to the mix.
Wait, you're saying I could have my own AI spokesperson?
Pretty much. You could have a virtual spokesperson creating tons of video content.
That sounds straight out of a movie. But let's get practical here. Mm-hmm. How much more efficient can content creation really get with this kind of tech?
Well, Accucrazy is saying a writer using their tools could go from 2 articles a day to 500.
Seriously, 500 articles a day. That's like 480 times more efficient.
It's mind-blowing, right?
It is, but it also makes you think, what happens to all the writers if AI can do their jobs that fast?
Yeah, that's a real concern. The possibility of job displacement is definitely something we need to talk about. This technology is moving so quickly. We need to think about the ethical side of things too, you know.
Absolutely. It's not just about what the tech can do. It's about using it responsibly. Okay, but before we dive into all that, I want to get a sense of Accucrazy's big picture vision. Where do they see all of this going?
Well, they want to be the next Appear.
Oh, wow. Appear is huge here in Taiwan, right? Like a real unicorn in the ad tech world.
For sure.
So Accucrazy's aiming for that same level of success, but for content creation.
That's the goal.
That's ambitious.
Yeah.
But do they have the people and the resources to pull this off?
Well, their leadership team has people from companies like Asus and HTC.
So they've got experience at the top.
Yep, big time. And they're attracting some serious investors like AdData and maybe even Asus.
That's a big vote of confidence.
It is. Yeah. They've got the vision, the tech, the team, and the money. It seems like they're in a really good spot to make this pocket company a reality. But of course, any powerful technology has its downsides, right?
Oh yeah, for sure.
So what are some of the ethical concerns around this whole AI-powered content creation thing?
Yeah, that's a great question. It's one that we really need to be asking ourselves.
It is.
We've seen how these tools can make things super efficient.
Right.
And create personalized content. But what about the potential for misuse?
Like spreading misinformation.
Exactly. Or creating biased content.
Yeah, that's a real worry when AI gets this powerful.
And what about originality? If everyone's using the same AI tools,
right,
won't everything start to sound the same?
Good point. What happens to real creativity?
And what about ownership? If AI is doing the writing, who owns the copyright? These are some big questions we need to figure out.
They are. These are complex issues that we need to address as AI becomes more and more part of our lives.
Couldn't agree more. Mm-hmm. We need to have these conversations now while the technology is still developing.
Yeah.
To make sure that AI is used ethically and responsibly.
Absolutely. All right, so we've covered a lot here.
Fun.
From the technical side of Accucrazy's pocket company to the bigger questions about the future of content creation.
Right.
But before we wrap up this part of our deep dive, I want to hear your final thoughts. What's the one big takeaway you want our listeners to walk away with?
Well, for me, the biggest takeaway is this.
Yeah.
We are at a turning point. AI is not just some futuristic fantasy anymore.
It's here.
It's here. It's changing fast.
Fast.
And it's going to completely change the way we create and consume content.
No doubt.
With their pocket company idea, they're leading the way.
They are.
The question is, how do we deal with this new world responsibly?
Right. How do we use this power for good?
That's the challenge and the opportunity in front of us.
Big time.
And if you're interested in learning more about Accucrazy and the future of AI-powered content creation, go check out their website.
It's a goldmine of information. Their AI solutions, their vision, their team.
It's definitely worth a deep dive of your own.
Yeah.
Thanks for joining us. We'll be back soon to continue exploring this topic.
See you then. You know what's interesting, though? It's not just about the technology itself.
Right.
It's about their strategy.
Yeah.
Accucrazy seems to get that AI isn't about replacing humans, you know?
Yeah, it's more like a collaboration, right?
Totally. It's about working together. They actually say it in their marketing materials.
Oh, yeah. What do they say?
Not to replace humans, but to create AI for good or something like that.
I think I saw that, too. It seems like they're really focusing on the good that AI can do.
Yeah, they are. That idea of empowerment rather than replacement.
Right, like using AI to help people, not put them out of a job.
Exactly. And they're really pushing this idea of creating content that feels real.
Yeah, authentic.
Personalized, you know.
Well, I think that's key. We're all so tired of generic content.
Right? So if they can tailor those messages, make it personal.
That's powerful stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Let's talk money for a sec.
Yep.
We talked about their fundraising, but do we know how much they're trying to raise?
Yeah. They're looking for $1 million this round.
Okay.
The valuation after that would be like 5 million.
Wow.
Their last round was valued at 700,000, so they're definitely on the up and up.
Those are some serious numbers. And yeah. What are they going to do with all that cash?
They've got a pretty clear breakdown of where it's going.
Okay.
A lot of it's going to their brand platform team, their AI data team, their SaaS team.
So they're building a solid foundation.
Yeah. Making sure they can actually support all this growth. And of course, you got to market the product.
Of course.
15% of the funds are going to marketing. They're digital marketing experts. They know what they're doing.
They've got the experience, yeah.
They even say they're going to use their past marketing wins as a model.
Smart move. Okay, we've talked about the company, but what about the people behind it all?
Yeah, the brains behind the operation.
Who are these AI gurus?
Well, first you've got CEO Ian Wu.
The top dog.
The mastermind behind this whole pocket company idea.
Okay.
They call him the brain.
That's fitting.
Yeah, he's lectured about AI and marketing at tons of universities.
Impressive. Who else is on the leadership team?
Okay, so there's Jack Chang, the CTO. He's the AI pursuer.
Okay.
Then there's Shelly Chen, the CMO and BD head.
That's a lot of hats.
Yeah, she's the queen bee.
I love these nicknames. It sounds like a really strong team.
They are. Tech experts, marketing pros, experienced leaders.
Yeah, and they've even got a chief scientist.
Oh, yeah, Chris Chang. The PhD.
Shows you how seriously they take R&D.
Oh, for sure. Plus, they've got advisors with experience in venture capital and startups.
Wow, they've assembled a real dream team. Okay, so where do they go from here? What's the long-term plan?
Well, right now, they're focused on getting this pocket company up and running.
Makes sense.
They're already working on those projects we talked about, like Moana.
Yeah, the social media AI.
And Pocket News.
The AI news agents.
They're also looking for collaborations, you know?
Yeah, I think I saw something about partnerships with Asus and NVIDIA.
Right. Working with other big players in the AI world. That's smart.
It is. They can share resources, learn from each other.
It's a win-win. Speaking of win-win, what are some of the benefits for Accucrazy's clients?
Yeah, good question. We talked about efficiency and personalization, but what else is there?
One of the biggest things they're highlighting is content at scale.
What does that mean?
So think about it.
Okay.
A brand could make hundreds, even thousands of pieces of content.
Yeah.
All targeted to different audiences.
Yeah.
And across multiple platforms.
Yeah.
And they could do it with almost no human effort.
That's pretty revolutionary.
Hmm.
But with all this talk about AI taking over,
yeah.
What about human creativity?
Right. That's important too.
Does that still matter in this new world?
Totally. AI can do the grunt work, the actual content generation.
Right.
But it's still us humans who come up with the ideas, the creativity.
The jerk.
Exactly. We bring that emotional intelligence, that human touch.
So it's not AI versus humans. It's about working together.
Absolutely. AI enhances what we can do.
Frees us up to focus on the big picture.
Yeah. The strategy, the storytelling, that's something AI just can't do.
That's reassuring. It's about finding the right balance.
It is. But let's talk content types. We've talked about articles and videos.
Yeah.
Can it handle other formats like social media posts, email campaigns?
Ooh, could it write a podcast script?
Maybe. That's where their chain of thought model comes in.
Oh, right. The thing that makes their AI think like a human.
Exactly. They say this tech lets their AI handle lots of different formats.
Like
blog posts, press releases, social media captions, even video game scripts.
No way. So it's not just churning out the same generic text over and over?
Nope. It can adapt to different styles and tones.
Wow. And what about that digital human technology?
Oh, yeah. That opens up a whole new world. Like, imagine having a lifelike AI avatar.
Like a virtual spokesperson?
Yeah. Or imagine it hosting an online event. That's wild.
It is, but it also makes me think about, you know, authenticity.
Right.
Transparency.
Yeah. How do we know when we're talking to AI?
As AI gets more sophisticated,
right,
and better at being like us,
it's going to be harder to tell the difference.
Transparency is going to be so important.
Oh, for sure. People need to know when they're interacting with AI.
Whether it's a chatbot, a virtual influencer.
Or even a digital news anchor. Yeah.
It's about building trust. Okay, let's shift gears a bit.
Yeah.
We've talked about the potential for job displacement.
Mm-hmm.
But are there any positive impacts on the workforce that we should consider?
Yeah, definitely. While AI might automate some jobs, it could also create new ones.
Yeah. How so?
Well, somebody has to develop these AI systems, implement them, maintain them.
Good point. So it's not necessarily humans versus AI.
No, it's about humans and AI working together.
Finding that balance.
Yeah, using AI to enhance human capabilities.
Freeing us up to do more creative and fulfilling work.
Exactly. But that means we need to think about education and training.
Right. How do we prepare people for this new world?
We need to invest in programs that teach people those new skills, you know?
Practical skills.
Yeah, but also critical thinking, problem solving, creativity.
Those schools are going to be even more important, right?
Oh, yeah, for sure. Okay, we've covered a lot.
We have.
From the nuts and bolts of Accucrazy's tech to the bigger picture of how it's going to affect all of us.
Businesses, individuals, society.
It's big stuff. But before we move on, I want to bring it back to the idea of the pocket company.
Yeah, it's a catchy name, but what does it actually mean?
So imagine having access to all these AI tools, right?
Right.
To handle content creation, social media, market research, data analysis.
It's like having a whole team of virtual experts.
Exactly. That's the promise of the pocket company.
Yeah.
But it also makes you think about control, right?
Yeah. If we're giving so much power to AI.
Yeah.
How do we make sure it's aligned with our values, our goals?
That's where humans are still crucial.
We need to set the guidelines.
Yeah. Ethical frameworks, oversight mechanisms.
It's about responsible use of AI.
It is. So it's a partnership, you know?
Yeah. A collaboration.
Humans and AI each bring something to the table.
Right.
AI can process data, find patterns, generate content like crazy.
And humans bring creativity, critical thinking.
That emotional intelligence, that ethical judgment.
By working together,
we can achieve so much more.
That's a great way to put it. Okay, we've explored a lot in this deep dive.
Yeah, for sure.
The tech, the implications for all of us.
The good, the bad, the future.
But before we move on to the final part, I want to leave our listeners with one last question to think about.
Mm-hmm.
If we're really going to embrace this whole AI thing,
yeah,
what skills do we need? You know, to really thrive in this new world, what do we need to learn as individuals and as a society? That's something I've been thinking about a lot.
It's a great question to end on. It really brings it back to the human side of things, you know?
Yeah, like, it's not enough to just be impressed by AI.
Right.
We need to think about it critically.
Yeah.
Ethically.
For sure.
Engage with it thoughtfully.
It's a powerful tool, but it's up to us to use it wisely.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
AI has so much potential.
Yeah.
But it's a double-edged sword, right? We need to make sure it benefits everyone.
Totally. Okay, I think it's time to wrap up our deep dive.
Yeah, I think so too.
We've covered a lot about Accucrazy and their pocket company.
We have. From the technical stuff.
All those AI models.
To the bigger picture.
How it's going to change content creation, the workforce.
I hope everyone listening learned something new.
Yeah.
Got curious.
Sparked some ideas.
Maybe even had a few aha moments.
I always say a little bit of skepticism is healthy, you know?
Especially with a technology this powerful.
Yeah, things are changing fast. So keep exploring, keep asking questions, keep learning.
That's the best advice.
Yeah.
Thanks for joining us, everyone. We'll see you next time on The Deep Dive.